but together. Sort of a yin and a yang, a positive and negative. Smoothing the rim, taking away a little bit of extra water. And believe me, you guys are all going to be doing this in just a few minutes. So get ready. Okay. Now I seem to have most of the clay up into the wall. I want to, just for the heck of it, let's go ahead and make a little shape. So now changing the pressure that I use on the clay as I go, I can make it fuller. I can make it narrower. And I can make a big change in what was just a cylinder a few moments ago. Now I can make it into a very round piece. Exciting, huh?
That's really cool.
You'll be done in a minute. Okay. A minute. Serious. And I can even use some pressure from the outside. You imagine strangling that chemistry teacher you had. I mean, that evil person. And there you go. That's called collaring. So now we've brought it in. Much narrower. And if we wanted to, we could even make it come out again. And it's all just the opposition, different pressures in different directions. Once you have the wall up, you can make all sorts of different shapes. You can bring it over if you like. Now we just have a simple wooden tool called the J tool. I'm going to use that. You see, we just have a little bit of excess clay down here. I'm just going to use that, cut away that excess. Bring away that extra clay to give us more of a finished looking piece. And there you have it. Believe it or not, you guys will be doing this in just a few moments. Do you know where the, thank you so much, Ellen. We just got a wire here. It's going to help us take the pot off the wheel. Just going to remove that again. One more time, a little water. And then we have the bat nearby. Ellen, you're so good. Shut off the power. Okay. And then we have another surface. These flat surfaces are called bats. And then you just take it right off, and there it is. Voila. Now you guys are all going to learn how to make it right now. So it's okay.